Hi, I'm Peter Rogers, MD, and in this lecture we're going to talk about hysterectomies. And so the question is, what is the significance of a hysterectomy for a woman? And of course, it depends. And when I say it depends, there's more risks involved if the woman has the hysterectomy before the age of 35 years, okay? Basically, the younger she is, the more of these atherosclerosis type risks there are. If a woman has a hysterectomy more around the age of 50, when she'd probably be about to undergo menopause anyways, it's less significant. So, with regard to hysterectomy, first thing is, what's the reason why women have a tendency to get hysterectomies at a younger age? Most often, in my experience, it's from things like fibroid tumors being symptomatic or things like endometriosis, okay? By the way, and this is an important point, there's a much increased incidence of fibroid tumors of the uterus and of endometriosis in women who have high estrogen levels. So in one of my other lectures, I went through a lot of the reasons why women have estrogen. One of the most common reasons, of course, is just eating meat. The liver excretes excess estrogen from your body by conjugating it, for example, with glucuronic acid. It is then released into your intestinal tract with the bile, and typically you poop it out. However, when a woman eats a lot of meat, the meat changes the colon bacteria and makes them of a type, meat-based bacteria, because basically meat is protein and fat. Plants are carbohydrate and fiber. So they cause a different type of gut flora. I'm 100% plant-based diet eater, and this is one of the reasons here as well, because the meat-related bacteria will tend to deconjugate that estrogen, separate it from the glucuronic acid. Then the estrogen in your gut will be reabsorbed into your blood, raises your estrogen levels, all right? Increased estrogen stimulates proliferation of cells in the uterus, thereby can cause the fibroid tumors of the uterus. It's a benign tumor of the uterus, like a leiomyoma is the other name for it. In addition, it can cause endometriosis because the estrogen stimulates more glandular proliferation in the uterine lining, the endometrium. All right, so it'll increase the risk of endometriosis. So one of the things you can do if you've got fibroids and you want to avoid fibroids, you want to avoid endometriosis, try reducing your meat intake and try avoiding estrogenic chemicals as much as you can, and you will thus decrease the likelihood of those things being a symptomatic problem for you. Okay, so we talked a little bit about the effect of estrogen on the uterus, stimulating cell growth. The next thing is hematocrit. When a woman menstruates every month, she's in a sense giving herself a therapeutic phlebotomy, like drawing blood therapeutically. Okay, and there's a couple vascular benefits from that. Number one, the main thing that determines how thick your blood is your hematocrit. Your hematocrit is the percent of your blood that's made up of red blood cells. Red blood cells are by far the dominant, most common cell in your blood. That's why your blood is red. And when you lower your hematocrit, the percent of red blood cells in your blood becomes thinner, more like water than like a thick substance like a milkshake. So a menstruating woman will have a little bit lower hematocrit, for example, than a man of the same age. And therefore, she'll have thinner blood. That's called lower viscosity blood. Lower viscosity blood, being more like water than a milkshake, is easier for the heart to pump. Women tend to have lower blood pressures. Women tend to have less atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis, the number one risk factor is high blood pressure. If you look at the statistics for myocardial infarction, most common cause of death in this country is myocardial infarction. About 26% of deaths are due to myocardial infarction. Well, guess what? Women almost never have a myocardial infarction before they become postmenopausal. After they become postmenopausal, their rate of myocardial infarction starts rapidly going up. Okay, so the point I want to make is every month a woman menstruates, she's lowering her hematocrit, therefore lowering her blood viscosity, therefore lowering her blood pressure, therefore lowering her incidence of atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis causes myocardial infarctions of the heart, and it also causes strokes. The next thing is, when red blood cells are lost due to menstruation, new red blood cells have to be produced in the bone marrow, and then they are then passed into the blood. The young red blood cells, when they first come out of the bone marrow, they're more flexible. It's sometimes called flexibility. It's sometimes called RBC deformability. The point being is, red blood cells, when they pass through a capillary, they have to have a slight shape change. Capillary and a red blood cell are about the same size, 5 to 7 microns. Okay, so the red blood cells are more flexible, more deformable to pass through those capillaries when they're young, just out of the bone marrow. So a woman also has lower blood pressure and lower blood viscosity because her red blood cells is a higher percentage of young ones that are more deformable, and therefore, again, lower blood pressure, less atherosclerosis. All right. When a woman gets a hysterectomy, let's say, especially before the age of 35, she now will stop menstruating every month. So she loses that protective effect of menstruation. Her red blood cell flexibility becomes worse. Her hematocrit is increased. So she starts to take on the same similar risk factors for atherosclerosis as a man has. And, you know, some women are not as careful as men about their atherosclerosis. Guys start getting scared as they approach 40 because they know about other guys who've had myocardial infarctions, strokes, who have become impotent. Okay, it's kind of scary. The arteries to the brain, the carotids, are about 6 millimeters in diameter. The artery to the heart, coronary artery, is about 3 millimeters in diameter. The artery to the Johnson is only about 1.5 millimeter in diameter, approximately, the pudendal arteries and whatnot. The point being is quite often impotence is the first manifestation of symptomatic atherosclerosis a guy experiences. So, not good. Guys don't want that. So a lot of guys are starting to be pretty careful and they start really minimizing their meat intake and their other atherogenic risk factors like tobacco or junk food and whatnot. Whereas if a woman's not worried about, you know, impotence, of course, and knows that women don't tend to have myocardial infarctions, she may not realize if she's had a hysterectomy before 35, she's at increased risk. As a matter of fact, one of the things I do, one of my fields, I'm a neuroradiologist, I look at brains. And if I see a lousy looking brain in a woman, let's say in her 50s or around 60-ish, and there's no explanation for it, she's not a smoker, she's not super obese, I say, well, why does her brain look so bad? Why does she have all these strokes? And I can tell you, a common reason for that clinical scenario is because she had a hysterectomy in her 30s, all right? And if you look, the Mayo Clinic's followed thousands of patients with hysterectomies, and they've noted that women who get a hysterectomy before the age of 35 increase incidence of coronary artery disease, that's atherosclerosis in the heart, increase incidence of congestive heart failure, like, you know, 4.6 times more. That's a lot, okay, within their 22-year follow-up period. And there's other studies showing women have an increased incidence of becoming demented. There's different types of dementia. The main kind we'd be talking about here would be what's called VCI, vascular cognitive impairment due to atherosclerosis. Basically loss of brain tissue because the arteries are plugged up by atherosclerosis. So the woman has an increased risk of becoming demented from a hysterectomy in her 30s. So my advice is, if you can, try to avoid the hysterectomy at a younger age by having lowering your estrogen levels. If you have to get the hysterectomy, then be aware that you now have increased risk of atherosclerosis like myocardial infarction and stroke and whatnot and hypertension. So minimize your cholesterol and try to minimize all your atherosclerosis risk factors so you can prevent developing dementia or congestive heart failure. And that's it.